North America is the world's largest illicit drug market, with Americans getting high in record numbers. This insatiable demand has created powerful and violent drug empires who use brazen, outrageous, and deadly smuggling methods to get their illicit cargo across borders of the US.
They're moving tons of drugs at this moment. There's probably tons of drugs en route to different places in the United States.
The billion-dollar drug cartels use every smuggling method imaginable to transport their deadly cargo. Everything from helicopters and gliders to trucks and human mules. But their trafficking mode of choice is by sea.
Okay, we're currently on top of what appears to be two launches heading basically eastbound.
This customs and border protection surveillance footage recorded drug runners minutes before being interdicted and then arrested. Incredibly, 80% of all illegal drugs entering the US arrives by sea.
Yeah, he's still turning south.
The US Customs and Border Protection Agency uses high-tech P-3 aircrafts in an effort to stop this sea invasion. These high-altitude airplanes patrol the open waters 24 hours a day, on the hunt for high sea drug runners who will do just about anything to avoid capture. In May 2005, a P-3 was on a mission off the coast of Ecuador on the hunt for the Simon Bolivar, a fishing boat believed to be transporting drugs.
We were suspecting that this boat was carrying a large load, a multi-ton load, up towards Mexico for offload to smaller vessels off the Mexican coast.
Bravo 2, affirmative. Boarding team is on board.
Recording the mission from 6 kilometers, the P-3 crew contacted a nearby Navy ship, USS Jarrett. They immediately launched a US Coast Guard boarding team. As the team approached, a crewman on the Simon Bolivar was seen throwing something overboard.
Something was just thrown over at 0343 South.
If you see anything go over the side prior to a boarding, that really raises your suspicion level, because normally the captains don't do that. If they start chucking stuff over the side, something's not right.
It was not long before the Coast Guard pulled alongside the fishing boat.
The armed boarding team now comes alongside and physically takes over the ship.
Okay, boarding crew is about to jump aboard the Simon Bolivar. They're on board.
But the captain of the Simon Bolivar then made a desperate and dangerous move.
At that point, we see the ship go out of control.
Break, ocean, ocean.
He's turning, Matt. He's circling there.
The Navy ship who's right next to him sees the ship go out of control. And you don't know if the captain is trying to hit and sink his own vessel because of the amount of drugs on board.
The fishing boat headed straight for the Navy ship. Both vessels only suffered minor damage. A search confirmed the P-3 crew's initial suspicions. The fishing boat was loaded with illegal drugs.
12 crew members were on board. 8,800 pounds of cocaine was taken off the boat. It's probably up in the $300 or $400 million range.
Fishing boats can camouflage a drug load, but when it comes to outrunning the law, a favorite choice for smugglers is a fast boat. They've been used by smugglers since the days of prohibition in the 1920s. Today, drug runners mount 4 outboard motors onto a 15-meter long fiberglass boat and achieve a top speed of over 160 kilometers per hour. Fast boats can easily outrun and outmaneuver most of the standard vessels used by law enforcement.
Looks like a bunch of packages in center hole.
2010, 160 kilometers off the northern coast of Panama. P3 FLIR footage recorded the USS Freedom's encounter with a fast boat that was showing all the signs of smuggling.
A multi-engine, running at night, lights out at high speed. Those are things that we used to identify it as a suspect vessel.
The Navy vessel attempted to intercept the suspicious fast boat.
You have to remember, out in the middle of the ocean at night, it is pitch black dark.
We got in a little bit lower and closer. It looked what appeared to be contraband loaded up in the front of the boat.
Yeah, the whole center forward looks like packages, barrels. We're not really sure.
Then the fast boat made a run for it. The Navy ship immediately launched an RHIB, a rigid-hulled inflatable boat that carried a heavily armed arrest team. These lightweight, high-performance Navy chase boats travel at speeds of up to 130 kilometers per hour. As the Navy RHIB closed in on the fast boat, the smugglers took decisive action.
This is 106. 106 is taking this target right here, right now.
The go-fast becomes evasive and turns hard.
He's getting close. He's got him. He's got him.
And rams the rib and takes out his engines.
So that boat was instantly disabled.
The USS Freedom continued the chase until the smugglers beached their boat and escaped into the dark. But they didn't get far, thanks to a quick call to Panama's National Police.
Local Panamanian law enforcement were able to arrest three of them, and they were able to seize over 2,600 pounds of cocaine.
The good guy boat is shining a spotlight on the bad guy boat.
Just a few months later, another fast boat beaching took place in Panama. This case began when a suspected smuggling boat spotted the P-3 surveillance airplane, dumped its drugs, and made a run for it.
There's definitely a lot of stuff in the boat. Looks like you might be dumping some more stuff here. Yep, one.
And once they know that they have been found, they try to throw the drugs overboard and basically get rid of the evidence.
How many objects? Okay, it's about five, six, seven.
We mark the position of each bale that goes overboard, that we count each bale so we know how much was there. So after the mission is over, we can go back to the debris field and recover those bales of cocaine.
But the drug bales weren't the only thing that went overboard. The smugglers suddenly leapt from the fast boat, a dangerous and potentially fatal tactic.
Another large object at 0921-0794.
The individuals on the boat actually jump off. They're hoping, I guess, that the boat will continue on and safe on shore, and the plane and the law enforcement vessel will follow the boat.
With no one at the helm, the fast boat careered out of control.
But indeed, it made a full circle back to them.
Okay, yep, the people in the boat have jumped out, and the boat is in orbit.
And eventually launched itself up on the beach line, and you can see as it goes into the village.
It beached itself. We'll give you a position.
The fast boat and remaining drugs came to a crashing halt in the center of the village. A rude awakening for the sleeping inhabitants.
The people from the village were coming out to see where the boat crashed into a couple of structures.
The U.S. Navy recovered 89 bales of cocaine worth $362.4 million and three waterlogged suspects.
The boat can come in and get the bundles before someone else gets them.